The trip that I went on was a plant pathology in tropical climates course. It was called Tropical Plant Pathology. It was a one-week trip to Costa Rica, and we were accompanied by Dr. Restaino, who is a faculty member in the plant pathology course. My name is Bridget Lassiter. I'm a PhD candidate in crop science, and I'm minoring in plant pathology. We met in the spring semester, and we met for about 7 or 8 weeks and had different guest speakers that came and spoke to us about Central America, crop production, different plant pathology that you have to be aware of in tropical environments. And then we reconvened in the summertime, and we all went down to Costa Rica. We traveled to a banana plantation. We traveled to a coffee farm and a coffee cooperative that's run by growers and people in government that are working on coffee research. We traveled to a Dole pineapple plantation and a sugarcane farm. We traveled to the botanical gardens at Cartier and looked at chocolate or cacao, which is the crop that you turn into chocolate. And on the last day, we visited several different places where we viewed root crops, such as cassava, taro, yam, and ginger. And we also visited an ornamental plant farm. My favorite crop that we saw on this trip was bananas. We were at a big corporate plantation. We were traveling around that farm with a guy, I believe his name was Jose, and he said, "I want you to think about how much work goes into these bananas when you go back to Food Lion and you're able to get a bunch of bananas and buy them for 50 cents a pound. Banana trees are like probably 20 or 30 feet tall. They usually are thinned down, and so they only have one bunch that hangs from each tree. And that bunch can weigh between 50 and 70 pounds. And all of the bananas are harvested by hand. I think the bananas are growing for about 20 weeks. And about halfway through that time, they will put a plastic bag around the banana bunch, protect the banana peels. After that 20 weeks, they cut down a bunch of bananas with a machete by hand. They load them onto this contraption that's pulled by donkeys on a wire cable. And they place these cloth things, they called them diapers, but they place them between each finger of bananas, which is like a bunch, so that even when they were hauling them up to the packing shed, they weren't hitting each other and getting bruised. And then they get sprayed off, they get taken to the packing shed, they get washed, they get measured, they get rated, then they go into a float tank, and then they get packed into a box and shipped to the U.S. Central America is important because we get so many of our food crops from Central America. When you go to the grocery store and you pick up a pineapple or a banana, if you look at the little sticker on that pineapple or that banana, you'll see a lot of times that it's from Central America. The experiences that you get by traveling are sometimes scary, sometimes uncomfortable, but they're always new and rich and exciting, and it just helps you to understand where you are in the world and how different other parts of the world are.